It was mostly cloudy today with some light rain around North Parramatta, Kings Langley and Peakhurst. On the North Shore, Balmoral Beach looked a little bigger than usual thanks to an extremely low tide, a result of the new moon in our skies tonight. It was 2 to 5 degrees cooler than average, only reaching 23 degrees in Penrith, Blacktown and Liverpool, 22 in Gosford and Terry Hills, 23 degrees in the city and in Cronulla. We saw rain across the northeast today, 16 millimetres falling in Ballina, 14 in Coffs Harbour and 9 millimetres in Grafton. While rain and storms moved through the southwest in the Riverina this afternoon, we saw 17 millimetres of rain fall in Albury and 16 in Young. Temperatures were mainly cooler than average, only reaching a top of 23 degrees in Bathurst and Newcastle, 25 the top in Mudgee, Coffs Harbour and in Grafton. Tomorrow, humid easterly winds on the Queensland and northern New South Wales coast will cause some showers, with troughs generating storms across other parts of New South Wales and into Victoria. Let's take a look around the country tomorrow. Brisbane will see a few early showers, heading for a top of 28 degrees, a shower or two for Canberra, 23. Partly cloudy in 23 in Melbourne, cloudy in 17 in Hobart, sunny in Adelaide and sunny in Perth as well, heading for a top of 31 degrees. We'll see showers across most of southern New South Wales tomorrow, with storms firing up again, as well as a few more showers on the far north coast. The heaviest rain is expected around the Riverina and the southwest slopes, with falls of 10 to 15 millimetres. We will see lighter falls elsewhere. It will be a little warmer than today, heading for tops of 26 degrees in Bathurst, Batemans Bay and Bega, 28 on the way for Newcastle and Grafton and 30 in Mudgee. After possible fog in the outer west, Sydney will be partly cloudy tomorrow morning. There is a medium chance of showers as well as a possible storm, most likely in the west in the afternoon and evening. We're not expecting a lot of rain in it, up to a millimetre in the city, if anything, and up to 3 millimetres in our west. It will start to heat up again, heading for tops of 27 to 29 degrees across our western suburbs, 26 in Gosford, 25 in the city and 23 in Cronulla. Let's take a look ahead, and there's showers possibly every day until this time next week, but the amount is still quite variable. Thursday we'll see up to 8 millimetres, 28 degrees, 2 to 10 millimetres on Friday, 26, with showers across the weekend, tops of 25 degrees, those overnight lows hovering around 18 to 19. In our west, showers and 30 degrees on Thursday, a few showers and 27 on Friday, with wet weather over the weekend as well. Those overnights range from 16 to 19 degrees. Georgie?
Amber, thank you.
Hello again from Yarrawonga on what has been a showery day across Victoria. The heavier falls have avoided us here though. We've only had a millimetre and earlier today it reached a mild top of 24 degrees. These cloudy skies are a rarity though. Yarrawonga is known as sun country on the Murray and has more hours of sunshine than the Gold Coast, as well as an extended summer. It has a dry, crisp winter, which is perfect for golf. And Australia's 72nd ranked golf course, the Black Bull, is part of the Seabull Yarrawonga Resort, so you can play and stay. It's situated on the beautiful Lake Mulwala, making it a haven for water sports. Just a 3-hour drive from Melbourne and you're sitting by the water enjoying the stunning sunsets. The close proximity makes it an ideal destination for a weekend or midweek getaway. And while you save on airfares, you can splurge on a little luxury. The city's only had light showers on its way to a top of 19 degrees, but there's been heavier rainfall in the outer east, 13 millimetres at the basin. The most severe weather has been in the state's northeast, with widespread storms and a significant band of rain with totals up to 30 millimetres so far. Tomorrow's storms in the east are expected to deliver another 25 millimetres, possibly 50 if severe. Central districts should only get a light shower or two. And it'll be mostly dry and sunny in the west, warming up to the mid to high 20s, the low 30s in the Mallee. The wonderful town of Rutherglen is the next stop on our road trip. We're expecting a top of 25 degrees. We could get to see a few more showers, but with so much on offer, there will be no raining on our parade. For Melbourne, showers will become less likely as the night goes on, then less than a millimetre through outer northern and eastern suburbs tomorrow, and it'll be warmer than today, climbing from the mid-teens up to 23 and 24, 25 degrees at Yarra Glen. For the city, a low of 16 and a partly cloudy top of 23. 24 degrees on Thursday with light showers in the north and east. Friday should be dry and 21, 21 degrees on Saturday as well. Sunday will be cloudy, 23, a possible shower and 21 on Monday. And at this stage, showers and 24 degrees next Tuesday. Visit Victoria is helping us to spend time in parts of our state recovering from the devastating floods of last year. Its warmer climate makes it a great spot to head for the Easter holidays, and you can linger a little longer in Yarrawonga and sneak in a cheeky round of golf feet.
That sounds absolutely wonderful. Thank you, Lavinia.
Thanks, Cade. Cooling off a little bit, it's around 25 degrees in the city at the moment. That was after our top of 28.5 degrees today. It's been a bit of a funny day. It started out quite showery. There's even been some storms around, but now things have cleared on up. So across the suburbs, yeah, look, we saw a good 2 millimetres up at Golden Grove, and then a lot of areas, suburbs through the south, saw around 0.5 millimetre. Not everywhere got something, but most areas did. And temperature-wise, it was pretty warm, 28 degrees at Moreton Lakes today. A very active radar through our north with plenty of lightning embedded in the showers. Nothing too heavy though. We got about 0.5 millimetre at Whyalla and Port Pirie, and about the same through much of the Barossa and the Riverland. Temperature wise it was 28 at Nuriutpa. So you can see on the charts here the blue blobs or the showers of the weather there moving off towards the eastern states, and in their wake it's a much more settled picture remaining for South Australia. If you're travelling though, you could follow the storms. They'll turn up in Canberra. Sydney is also looking showery with the chance of a storm, and showers clearing in Brisbane. So here we go for SA. Out comes the sun again tomorrow, and plenty of it. Port Augusta sunny in 33, Port Pirie 32, and Clare a sunny 29 degrees in store. Nuriutpa is also looking clear with a mostly sunny 29 degrees and Renmark 31. And then as we move to the southeast, we drift back into the 20s with 28 at Narracourt and 26 at Mount Gambier. On local waters, southeasterlies to around 10 knots, becoming south southwesterly 10 to 15 knots in the middle of the day, and tending south to southeasterly in the evening. It's a warm one across our suburbs tomorrow, up to 30 at Elizabeth, 28 at Norlunga, and 27 at Mount Barker. Could still be a little bit gusty with the southeasterlies through the foothills overnight, but not like earlier this week. After that, tomorrow in the city, 28 degrees and an overnight low tonight of around 16 degrees. And then really, it's a very easy run towards the weekend with temperatures in the mid-20s for Thursday and Friday, looking around 25 degrees. Saturday, nice start to the weekend, looking dry with 25 degrees. There's just a chance of showers starting to creep back onto the forecast from Sunday.
Lofty, overnight, in fact, similar to this morning, early hours, it will dry up through the day, and there's the slight chance in the afternoon, but most of the rainfall will be during the early hours of the morning. So a few millimetres for the gauge again. We can do with a drop or two. Temperature-wise, it was slightly cooler today as we take a look at the flyover over southeast Queensland, courtesy of that southeasterly change, but still 1 to 2 degrees above average with all the suburbs, ranging from high 20s on the coast and bayside to low 30s here in the city and western suburbs. 31 the high for Gatton, Toowoomba the coolest city with 26, the state's high 39.4 in Birdsville. The weather map, showers and storms for just about every state and territory, the only exception South Australia, heaviest falls over the top end, northern Queensland and New South Wales. Interstate, sunny and warm for Perth and Adelaide, a shower in Melbourne, cloudy for Hobart, a couple of showers in Canberra and Sydney, showers and storms Darwin. Queensland looking at small wet weather in Cairns, those showers will ease, partly cloudy for Townsville, a couple of showers Mackay. Mostly sunny inland, we're looking at low to mid-30s through the interior. A little cloud for the Capricornia, tending to a couple of showers for the Wide Bay and Burnett. Here in the southeast, partly cloudy with morning showers, slight chance in the afternoon. Overnight temperatures between 18 and 22. Daytime highs, well, back in the mid to high 20s for the western suburbs tomorrow. Moreton Bay, southeasterly winds 15 to 20 knots, so a little uncomfortable on the bay and offshore with the seas to 1.5 metres. Brisbane, a few morning showers, clearing to a partly cloudy day, moderate southeasterlies and a top of 28 degrees. 7-day outlook, partly cloudy Thursday and 29. Early fog Friday followed by a sunny day. A shower or two over the weekend and into Monday with a possible storm. Daytime temperatures still around 30 each day. Ipswich, partly cloudy Thursday, 31. Friday, 33. A shower or two over Saturday, Sunday, Monday and a possible storm. For the Goldie, a little cloud and high 20s Thursday and Friday. A few showers possible over the weekend and into Monday with a chance of a thunderstorm. And on the Sunshine Coast, a couple of showers Thursday, mostly sunny Friday. There'll be a pick of the week, a shower or two across the weekend and into Monday, but still the chance of a storm and around 30 degrees forecast over the weekend. So tomorrow, guys, still 28 and on average, but it'll be the coolest day of the week.
Looking forward to it, Gary. Thank you.